Let's take a look at some of these composers here. These are three composers that I want to talk about concerning my own efforts there. Now, it may only look like one octave, but basically something like this you can do an awful lot with when you're looking for themes for your classical compositions. So, let's have a look at this. These are three people who are concerned with musical themes. Romantic era kingpin here. I don't know if you can see the it's a portrait of Tchaikovsky, and he's the came up with romantic melodies. Let's have a look. This is Mussorgsky, one of the five of the 19th century in Russia, and Tchaik and Mussorgsky were sort of like at variance there in their styles. And also here, now here is a figure in classical music that sort of does not ring terribly prominently, but he has a great following. This is Eric Satie, who came up with some really neat stuff. For example, his composition Trois Gymnopiestes. I think I pronounced it correctly. Three Gymnasts, anyway. So let's have a look at this. First of all, Tchaikovsky here. I gotta make sure that I don't have any beard hairs in my harmonica. Let's see. Let's see if I can do the Waltz of the Hours. You know, I usually can only do this when I'm not trying to record something. It's like, you remember, it's a very, very beautiful melodic type of song here, or theme in one of his compositions. I got in trouble at the end there, but also his work that he didn't really like it that much, the flag waving 1812 overture. Let's see if I can remember part of it. Goes through, and we'll skip part of it. And part of his piano concerto number one, let's see. Thank you. See, the romanticism, the melody. Now, let's have a look at... now, you got to remember I'm playing this by ear, so it's not going to be, you know, actually verbatim to the music. Let's have a look at Mussorgsky here. For example, his famous pictures at an exhibition, which later was made into a symphony by Ravel, if I'm not mistaken, famous bolero man, you know. You know, the Ravel did something like this. Mom, I'm to find it somewhere. Nah, I can't find it. I was going to do bolero, but I need to rehearse that. It's in there somewhere. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, like that. But anyway, here's Mussorgsky's picture at an exhibition, probably the first part there, the entrance. Oh, I'm trying to do this on a cam, and I'm getting nervous, so I can't find it. Oh, man. I lost the thread there. Now, all that, this is a piano, probably concerto or a composition that he did on piano. In other words, he's using a singular instrument to produce this symphonic work. So a lot of your work in progress can be done with a single instrument, even Beethoven himself. He was often observed walking through the park there, I think it was in Vienna or someplace, around midnight, he'd be out there walking around, pacing around, whistling his compositions, working on his music. All you need is this little octave. Now let's have a look at Eric Satie's work, the three gymnasts. I have one of the earliest cassette tape players in existence when I was driving a cab in New York City in 1970. And I was listening to this on many a night when I was driving down the East Side Highway, you know, at about 1 a.m, no clients, no customers in sight, headed down to my little secret area. I took Carmen Street to get to Bleecker Street, whereas everybody else, all the other cabs turned into Bleecker Street, and there, at least in 1970, the lights were timed in a certain way on, I think it was 7th Avenue, or 5th Avenue, one of them, And the taxis that turned in directly would wait, and it was my one trick. Now, a good professional cab driver has lots of those little things he or she knows about this a big city, secrets of the city. So there was always, turning on that street, there was always a customer, all hours of the night. Anyway, so I used to listen to this as I drove, and the city is this dark mauve color, like something out of a Batman comic book, you know, at that time of night, you know. Sometimes when it rained, you could see the traffic lights reflecting off of the shiny streets, the wet streets, and that was a little cheerful there. You had a little bit of a light show. Anyway, let's see. Yes, there is. You see that beauty in that, but see, Satie, these are 19th century folks, Satie, Mussorgsky, I hope I pronounced his name correctly, Mussorgsky, and Tchaikovsky, but especially these two. I don't know about Tchaikovsky, you know, what he used, but these other two would do compositions on one instrument, mostly the piano, I guess. So that is your lead to your symphony. Once you get the symphonic work going, now you can play with this huge orchestra, which your notes can go from about five chords of five to chords of 20 to chords of literally hundreds. I think the biggest one was, I'm forgetting now. Forgetting all this basic stuff. Let's see. Already, you can get up to like 150 instruments. Actually, there's really no limit. Quite a few people are writing classical music. But the problem with the classics in the late 20th century was they almost, I mean, dare I even say it, they almost died. But for me, what I do with the harmonica is when I have this one little octave that I can work with, so I can start working on my compositions. Now, here's an impromptu composition out of the blue. Let's see. We'll start with that note. That's an A, I think. See, you got a mood set there. And you work on that. Now you can build on those, work on them, get your concertos, your symphonies, your quartets, start to pull in the instruments, enjoy the sound of the indigenous instruments, or put in things like synthesizers, work on your percussion section, tuning the kettle drums, two kettle drums, 350 kettle drums operated by keyboard, you know. Plus, you can work on your all the other things. So you, once you start to go to the conservatorium or other places, if you've got the bucks for that, you can begin to really specialize in things. But, you know, before you get complexity, you have to have simplicity. So I just wanted to go over those big three. Some of them not seemingly so big, but some beautiful melodies, especially Satie, Eric Satie. Well, I guess that's it for now. See you later, hopefully. Take care.